heart of Silicon Valley, JVM Language Summit 2024 gathered top contributors to the JVM and JVM language ecosystems. The main underlying theme is how continued evolution to the JVM and JDK is a rising tide that lifts all languages. And this year's three-day agenda was packed with sessions on cutting-edge topics concerning Project Babylon, Leyden, Valhalla, and many more. Yes, we finally get a Valhalla update, chips, and an early access build to try. Welcome everyone to the Inside Java Newscast, where we cover recent developments in the OpenJDK community. I'm Anwari Anihalchanu, Java Developer Advocate at Oracle, and today's episode is covering the major news from JVMLS 2024 and, spoiler alert, contains video footage not yet released. Without further ado, let's dive into the JVM ecosystem filled with presentations from the brightest minds. This JVM Language Summit edition debuted with an inspiring welcoming note from George Sapp, reminiscing over Java's initial release process and how the new ways of working within OpenJDK community have strengthened the language and platform through better collaboration. And then the JVM heavy lifting subjects followed, starting with Brian Gutt's update on Project Valhalla, Java's epic refactor. This decade-scale engineering project has experimented with several VM prototypes, all of them paying particular attention to compatibility, while serving a bold, noble goal. Codes like a class, works like an int. There is a phased delivery plan for Valhalla, and those of you that follow conversations on the mailing list already noticed 4 JDK enhancement proposals being part of it. JDK enhancement proposal 401 on valid classes is part of the current Valhalla early access build and has a focus on semantic foundations and basic optimizations. Semantically, valid classes can have almost all features that identity classes have, but their key characteristic is the fact that they are freely copyable, which makes them easy to work from a compiler's point of view, hence enabling optimization. A draft JDK enhancement proposal on null-restricted types and initialization challenges it addresses, another JEP-in draft state on null-restricted value type class types, and JDK enhancement proposal 402 on the enhanced primitive unboxing. Brian Gutt's presentation offered context to how lengthy the path to simplicity often is. Almost 10 years of work on Valhalla to gradually withdraw and rethink at the many different technical aspects of unifying the programming model benefits of classes with the runtime behavior of primitives. And only when the full scope was realized, it became practical to find the simple solution hiding among complexity. Valhalla's progress is based on rethinking existing concepts, such as variable initialization. Dan Smith's session explained how Java handles initialization and dived into a new JVM concept, strictly initialized variables. This new initialization model offers better safety and unlocks performance improvements. Another example that illustrates the richness of the Java ecosystem is Loris Creantor and Remy Forak's research work towards generics reification. Loris and Remy showed an experiment for a possible path to generic specialization, which might inform future progress in Valhalla. For more whispers of Valhalla and how to get involved, watch the full-length talks. And now that we pass the gates of Valhalla, let's look at more performance updates from JVMLS 2024. Given the constant presence at Java conferences, attention from Spring Boot and Quarkus teams, plus its first early access build, a Project Leyden update was in order. The presentation given by Yoi Lam and Dan Hedinga contains empirical evidence for Leyden's optimizations, some of those being now visible as JDK enhancement proposals, ahead-of-time class loading and linking, unified ahead-of-time cache, ahead-of-time method profiling, and ahead-of-time code compilation. This early access build follows OpenJDK development and has focused its efforts on improving startup and warm-up of Java applications, having many ahead-of-time optimizations. Yoi acknowledged that Project Leyden is a community effort, engineers from various companies being involved in its success. If you are not yet convinced to give a try to this early access build, here is more. This episode offers a link to a small set of benchmarks, each using a major framework, Helidon, Micronaut, Quarkus, Spring Boot, that demonstrate Leyden's performance optimizations. Still not convinced? Leyden repository explains how to try its features, but most importantly, Dan has walked us through those in layman's terms during his presentation at JVMLS 2024. Another JDK improvement that keeps on giving is how string concatenation is treated by the Java compiler. The main theme of Clive Redestad's talk is how something seemingly known, such as string concatenation, is in itself a rabbit hole of surprising depth. Clive walked the audience through current implementation and past efforts, a few recent workarounds to avoid resource starvation issues when expressions get too complex, and a prototype that revisits string concatenation in order to improve significantly over the current baseline on startup, footprint, and warm-up metrics. Java applications have different performance needs, and it's important to identify and fine-tune those aspects that lower certain resource consumption while keeping our end users happy. While the size of Java object headers is not an obvious concern, every modern Java application cares about memory footprint. And the goal of Project Lilliput is to achieve a low memory footprint by exploring techniques that would downsize Java object headers in the hotspot JVM from 128 bits to 64 bits or fewer. Roman Kenke captivated the audience with a live coding session that demonstrates Lilliput 1 and 2 capabilities, and then dived into explaining the novelties brought by the second Lilliput experiment. Tiny class pointers, compact identity hash code, improved full GC forwarding table, and the fact that it reserves 4 bits in object header for Valhalla. And since we already touched on memory aspects, Eric Osterlund's presentation dived into how ZGC garbage collector continues to achieve less than 1 millisecond GC pauses, scale to terabyte sized heaps, all with minimal configuration. So take advantage of what Java offers today and prepare for an even more performant future. Current IT market seems to thrive on innovating powered by AI, and it relies on computing architectures that use more than one kind of processor or CPU core. Such systems, referred to as heterogeneous computing, benefit of CPU computing and can prove extremely useful in areas like artificial intelligence and machine learning, gaming and graphics rendering, or in data centers and high-performance computing. This past year progress of Project Babylon seems to prove how tangible it is to have Java on the GPU.
We disclosed what we were working on this, and in between then we've created a project, we've open sourced the code reflection in January, and we've made significant progress on the implementation of this and the design of this as we go forward. And we published a bunch of articles on code reflection. My goal on these articles was to sort of inspire people, not to necessarily go deep down into the design of it, to inspire people of what might be possible so that people can do their own things on what might be possible and surprise us. Because I think this project is, if people get involved in it, they're going to surprise us with what they can do.
This year's talk on code reflection with Project Babylon offers a brief summary on Project Babylon status, what are and how code models work, how to identify methods to get code models out, ways to access code models using reflection, and how reflection works with lambdas. If you want to access the code models, make sure to look at the existing core library APIs inside Babylon's test cases. I encourage you to watch Paul Sandel's talk because it lays the foundation needed to grasp how to translate Java to SPIR-V. SPIR-V is an abstract static single assignment assembly language, great for expressing parallel computing graphics. Steve Dorman's session explains how to use Babylon Code Reflection API to firstly translate Java to a SPIR-V code reflection dialect and then to a SPIR-V binary module to execution on a GPU. Yeah, Project Babylon also aims to solve some of Java general-purpose GPU compute pain points by leveraging Heterogeneous Accelerator Toolkit, HAT. In their joint talk, Gary Frost and Paul Sandels showcased how HAT targets heterogeneous devices offering while mediating interaction between the JVM and the native runtime. The toolkit offers a compute programming model for describing how kernels are to be dispatched, data models and patterns for representing off-heap data as Java interfaces. GPU compute requires to exchange data with GPU devices, and HAT leverages foreign function and memory API to achieve that. A pluggable backend abstraction to allow vendors to best showcase their own capabilities. This is a must-watch video because this session contains cool demos. Many sessions covered the future of the JVM and active OpenJDK projects, yet there are a few talks that celebrated Java and its friends. When we say JVM, our minds think of Java, but there are Java implementations of other programming languages atop the Java virtual machine. This is the case of JRuby that for the past 20 years brings the best of Ruby to the JVM world while herding the challenges of Ruby to the JVM. In the last day of JVMLS 2024, Charles Oliver Nutter, JRuby co-lead, shared insights on JRuby's performance, use cases, and the fact that in 2024, JRuby took a leap towards Java 17 and 21. It seems that the JVM's robustness keeps on giving for a 20-year-old project, and this should inspire you to adopt newer Java versions too. Speaking of stories down the memory lane of the JVM, James Gosling, the father of Java, joined the experts to hand out his lifelong insight stories on Java. Throughout his session, James has given accolades to Java language innovations like pattern matching and many more.
Thank you to everybody who's committed to all of the JVM work